Hey all, hope you all are coding great. I am Atar Tiwari and I welcome you all to a brand new YouTube video. So in this video we will just complete our HTML file for the smooth working of our application. So in this particular video we will just complete our HTML file, all that buttons part, and after buttons we will just code our where the meeting ID should be placed, where should be our video should be placed and all. So in this video we will just do that only, and in the next video we will see how the things will work with the help of JavaScript. So what buttons will the function of different buttons, and the function of our chat application, chat box. So in the next video we will just cover our JavaScript part. So let's don't just waste our time and let's get started. Okay guys, so now we are on our screen. So in this video we will just complete our front end part of our application. So in this video we will just code our HTML file and the second screen, the meeting grid for the which on which user will get its buttons, all the buttons, and the chat screen and the video screen, the participant view and the meeting ID. So in the previous video we have just created our meeting ID and the token, and in this video we will complete our front end part. So let me paste the code here. Okay, so I have pasted the code in this HTML file. So in the previous video we have in some of the previous video we have complete our code till here, till the create meeting part, that means the login screen part. But now we will add our common functionalities that will be useful for recording the meeting, to share the screen, to mute and disable mic and all, to raise the hand, to leave meeting, to end the meeting, to start video, stop video. There are different functionalities which we have provided. As you have seen in the previous video, we have declared various variables that will be used in this particular video. The variables are directly linked to this one: to pause video, to resume video, to seek video, to start video, to stop video. All the variables that that are declared in the previous video are having their buttons in on the front end part. So here is the coding of a chat wrapper. So as I have told you that we are also using we are also giving the user a chat window to chat with other users. So this is a chat wrapper. So here all the chat messages are stored, and this is the box. There is a white box for the chat, and here you can see input type for the chat message and then meeting ID. So it will also show the meeting ID. So it will show the meeting ID on the top of top right of the page. So I have coded it here, and then there is a participant wrapper. After that, after the meeting ID, we have a participant wrapper. So in this particular thing it will show the all the participants that are joined in this particular meeting. So here is the participant link, and that's all. So this is the normal code for our application. So let's run it. So let's run this code. Firstly let me save this code, and let me turn on our Node.js server. So for that we have to switch our directory to the Node.js folder, npm run start. So our Node.js server has been turned on, and after that we have to run our application. So for application I will run the application on live server, as you all know that. So so our application is now run. So now our application is running, as you can see here. So here is our video, and as we have coded in the previous HTML part, here is our meeting, here is our name, and here is our meeting ID. So to join in the meeting I just have to write my name here, and then I will click on create meeting. So after clicking on the create meeting, so here is our here is our So here is our meeting grid part. So now you can see there are different buttons here: start video, stop video, pause video, resume video, seek video, start recording, stop recording, mute mic and all. So there are different buttons for that. And also here is the chat window. After that, here is our meeting ID which we have created, and then the participant list. So this all we have coded, but these buttons are not working because of the reason that we have not coded their functionality part in our JavaScript file. So we will cover all this functionality part in some next of some videos. So till then, thank you for watching this video till then. If you like this video, just hit that like button below. Also subscribe to our channel. So till then, stay secure, stay safe, and happy coding to